Hi guys, and welcome back. So in this video, we're going to be trying out this cool new toy called Jelly World. I just came across this on Instagram and I thought it looks like the most satisfying thing I've ever seen because you basically get to make your own aquarium that's filled with some kind of jelly or slime. And you have these little toys that you can push inside and they stay suspended in that transparent fake water jelly substance. And you also get a pipette that you can use to make air bubbles, and these air bubbles also stay inside the jelly. So I'm really excited to try this out, and I'm also going to see if I can make a DIY version using normal craft supplies that everyone might have at home. So this video is not sponsored because I found and I bought these on Amazon using my own money. Even though I do actually have a contact with the company who makes this, which is Orb Toys, because they sent me some stuff last year from other videos. However, in this case, it really was just me finding something I saw on Instagram and I wanted to share with you guys, so I didn't want to go into the trouble of actually contacting the company. Therefore, I haven't been paid for this video. They don't even know I'm making this video. However, it is a form of advertisement because I am talking about a specific product for a very long time. I'm mentioning the brand names and I've linked it down below in case you want to get it. And that's the only reason why it's marked as advertising up here. And don't forget, you still have 2 weeks to get my limited edition rose gold koala t-shirt, which is right back there. And this is also marked as advertising because I'm obviously advertising my own merchandise, which is linked down below. So now without further ado, let's open this up. One thing that made me a bit apprehensive when buying this product was that it got pretty bad reviews on Amazon. Out of 4 reviews, it only seemed to work for one person, and all the other 3 just said it failed completely and was a waste of money. At $12 to $15, this is actually fairly expensive for a craft kit that you can only use once. However, I was willing to give it the benefit of the doubt because I'm a full-time DIY YouTuber, and this is a toy for 4-year-olds, so what could possibly go wrong? And as it turns out, a lot of things ended up going wrong, which you'll see in detail in this video. But in the end, I did manage to find a completely foolproof method of getting this toy to work, which is summarized in the timestamp shown on screen right now. First of all, this kit comes in 4 different colors with different characters inside. I got the blue, pink, and purple sets because I found these characters look the cutest. I like how some of these have an outer space or underwater theme, which fits with the magical floaty design of the product. So inside you'll get a flat plastic tank, some mixing tools, and a powder and liquid to create the jelly. To make the jelly, you'll also need a large plastic bottle and a measuring jug, which are not included in the kit. It's a pretty big coincidence because we're basically going to be using the same method as my bottle slime video. Before getting started, I noticed an important line from the instructions which said, "Jelly whirls will not work with hard water. If your tap water is hard, use bottled water." Since I wanted to do this DIY perfectly, I decided to go with bottled water from the start because I had to buy a bottle anyway to use for the mixing. The first step is to measure out 480 milliliters or 2 cups of room temperature water. Then fill this into the empty bottle. You'll notice that the water only comes up halfway, but this is actually important because you need a large air gap inside the bottle for all the ingredients to mix together. Now add the packet of gel fetti, which is a white powder that smells very faintly of plastic. Then replace the lid and shake for 20 seconds until everything is fully dissolved. Pour the mixture into the Jelly World tank and wait for 5 minutes. Once again, since I'm trying to follow the instructions as closely as possible, I even set a timer for each step of this DIY. Set alarm for 5 minutes.
I've set an alarm for 12:30.
After the time is up, pour the small bottle of jelly liquid into the tank, Mix it through thoroughly and leave everything to set. I started getting a bad feeling about this because the mixture looks very cloudy and nothing at all like the crystal clear jelly from the packaging. So while this was setting, I decided to make a second batch using tap water. I followed the exact steps as before, and this one is quite important because I'm assuming that the vast majority of people are going to be using tap water after buying this kit. Unfortunately, the liquid also turned very cloudy during shaking, and I was starting to get a bad feeling about this one as well. After adding the colored jelly liquid, I left it to set for 10 minutes. And lo and behold, both of my attempts were complete fails, despite following the instructions absolutely precisely and using two different types of water. The first one didn't jellify at all, so this is basically a layer of plain water over a kind of murky, jelly, plastic sludge. The second one did turn solid, but it was so cloudy that you can barely see anything you put inside. Now I can really understand how frustrating it must be if you're a parent and you bought this toy for your kids, only for it to end up looking like this and you don't even get enough materials to try again. Luckily, I ordered 7 of these kits for the exact possibility that something like this might happen, so I still have quite a few to experiment on. I want to try again, but in order to fix the problem, we have to understand what went wrong in the first place. This is not that easy because you never find out which chemicals are used in the kit. My first theory is that the gelfetti might be PVA powder and the small bottle of liquid is some type of borax solution. This would make it a classic slime recipe, which is easy to fix using stuff you have at home. I kept a bit of the powder and I'm going to test it out using my own slime activator. If it really contains PVA, then the powder has to clump together just like slime as soon as I add the borax solution. But unfortunately, this didn't seem to be the case. The powder simply absorbed the liquid and it turns grainy and crumbly, which is nothing at all like slime. However, this confirmed my second theory, which is that the powder must be sodium polyacrylate. This is a super water-absorbent polymer, which is basically the same as the slushy gel you find inside diapers. There are many different types of sodium polyacrylate, and they're used to make everything from diaper fillings to fake snow to Orbeez. Some types behave very similar to slime, such as that powder which you can add to your bathtub or pool, which turns everything into jelly. I'm pretty sure that Jelly Worlds works in exactly the same way. So now the big question is, why did the first one fail so badly when the instructions specifically told us to use bottled water? I got my answer after 5 minutes of Googling because the definition of hard water is water which contains a high percentage of minerals such as calcium and magnesium. The bottled water I used was mineral water, which actually contains more minerals than hard tap water. So that explains why the first one failed completely. I have to say that this was an absolutely terrible piece of instruction, because the vast majority of bottled waters are mineral waters. How the company expects an average person to know the difference between bottled water, mineral water, soft water, and hard water is a complete mystery to me, and I'm pretty sure that this contradictory line of text caused many people to waste their money on this kit. I did watch a few Jelly Worlds videos on YouTube, and those people did actually get a crystal clear result using tap water, so I think it really depends on where you live. Water hardness can differ hugely between different towns in the same country, so it's basically down to complete luck whether your tap water is soft enough to work for this DIY. So now that I understand exactly what went wrong, I'm going to repeat the experiment using the softest water I can find. I went out and I bought distilled water and baby water. Distilled water is created using condensed water vapor and it has almost no impurities or minerals inside. You can get this very cheaply from drugstores or gas stations. The second one is bottled baby water, which has a specially reduced sodium and mineral content. This doesn't taste very good, but apparently it's healthier for babies than normal tap or mineral water. Since the baby water comes in a 1-liter bottle, I'm going to start with this for the DIY. Just like before, I measured out 500 milliliters of water, added the gelfetti powder, and then shook everything together. Then I poured it into the tank and was disappointed to see that this one also turned out quite cloudy. You can't even see my hand when I pass it behind the container. The mixture does clear up a tiny bit when you leave it for 5 minutes, but it's far from transparent, which you can see when I add the purple liquid. While this is setting, I'm going to go for my final attempt using distilled water. This time, I mixed the powder in a measuring cup just to see if there's a difference, and it was actually a bit more difficult to get everything to dissolve. I ended up with a couple of lumps, which I got rid of by pouring it through a sieve. So right away, you can see that this mixture looks much more transparent, and I was completely shook. After so many fails, despite using the exact same method, I was ecstatic to see this finally start to work. I added the blue jelly liquid and left it to set. Now you can see a comparison of all 4 Jelly World's tanks. The first one didn't work at all, so this is basically a layer of plain mineral water above the sodium polyacrylate. The second one made using tap water did solidify, but it's very cloudy, so if you end up with something like this, then you need to try a softer water. You can actually add the toys to this, but the result is not very pretty or satisfying. The third one uses demineralized baby water, and it's a bit more transparent, but it's definitely not perfect. Just like the previous one, you can play with this if you want, but everything just looks a bit murky. And finally, the one made using distilled water turned out perfect. The jelly is crystal clear, and the consistency is also firmer than the other 3. This one is truly satisfying to play with. Simply take the plastic wand and push the toys inside, and you can also use the hooked end to reposition them. This is so bizarrely relaxing to do, and the closest I can compare it to is like a jelly version of a Zen garden. Then you can use the pipettes to add air bubbles. I realized that there's a special technique to doing this, because if you squeeze the bubble too close to the plastic, then it might simply roll up the side of the pipette and disappear. The trick is to hold the tip at an angle, or move it while squeezing air out, which helps the bubbles stay suspended in the jelly. Once you're done, you can replace the lid and keep it as room decor. Apparently, this is supposed to last a really long time. However, I'm a tiny bit skeptical because the lid feels quite flimsy. So I'm going to keep these in my office and post regular updates on Instagram. Be sure to follow me on Macaroon to see how long these hold up and if there are any differences between each one. So now that I've finally figured out how Jelly Worlds work, here's a foolproof guide on how to make it. You will need distilled water and a 1-liter plastic bottle. Measure out 480 milliliters and then pour it inside the empty bottle. I noticed after watching other videos on YouTube that many people had problems getting the powder to dissolve. To make sure this doesn't happen to you, be sure to use room temperature water, which means not warm, not cold, and a 1-liter bottle, not a smaller one. Having an air gap inside the bottle is crucial in getting everything to mix together properly. Then close the lid and shake everything really hard for about 20 seconds. Pour the solution inside your tank and leave it for 5 minutes.
The mixture should turn even more transparent during this time. Then add the jelly liquid and stir it through. I actually think that this bottle only contains water and food coloring because unlike slime, sodium polyacrylate doesn't need an activator. This makes the DIY slightly confusing because the steps appear to be a slime recipe, but in reality it has nothing to do with PVA or borate. Leave this to sit for 10 minutes and the mixture should turn into a crystal clear jelly. Now you can start having fun with it. Drop the toys inside and move them around using the jelly wand. I mentioned at the start that I'm going to try making a DIY version of this toy, and that's going to be coming in a future video. So please be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss out on the follow-up. I'm also going to be making my own toys from scratch using polymer clay for that, so if you've got any suggestions for themes or characters, then please leave it in the comments down below. Once you're happy with the position of your toys, take the pipette and finish up with some air bubbles. So here's a side-by-side comparison of the different Jelly Worlds tanks I made. I personally wouldn't even recommend trying to make this using tap water since there's too much of a risk it might fail. You don't get enough powder to try a second time, so it's much better to just spend one extra dollar buying distilled water, which you know will definitely work. Whatever you do, don't use bottled mineral water because that's going to cause it to fail completely like the one on the left.
I hope you enjoyed this video and please subscribe to Macaroon and Cute Life Hacks and follow me on Instagram under my username Macaroon. I'm Joanna, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!